Microsoft has a new channel chief for Canada.
And Microsoft also introduces a brand new channel program for Office 365. All that and more on this edition of the High Tech Countdown.
Hello everyone, I'm Paul Dunley-Blatto, the editor of CDN Computer Dealer News.
And I'm Christine Wong, a staff writer with itbusiness.ca. So as you mentioned before, Microsoft Canada does have a new channel chief. Tell us what you know about Impalo.
Well, it's Greg Larnder. He's VP of sales for the central region of CompuGen. Christine, as you know, CompuGen was the number one solution provider on CDN's top 100 list for the first time. He's definitely leaving that organization on top, so that's always a good thing. But I talked to channel partners at this show, and what they tell me is, you know, the big challenge for him going forward is he's going to have to know the LAR business, which is the large account reseller business. He's going to have to know the system integrator business and the VAR business. And right now, he really only has that piece working for a partner like CompuGen. He didn't run the LAR business at CompuGen. That was Michael Charter's job. So yes, he will have some challenges going forward. We did have an interview with him the other day. What are your thoughts on Greg Larnder?
Well, I think you're right that he will have some challenges. But on the other hand, he does have 27 years of experience in working with the channel. And one thing that he did note during our interview with him was that he just wanted to put it out there that this will be the first time that he has ever worked for someone directly who actually has experience themselves working in the channel. So what he's basically saying is these are people that he's now going to be working under understand the channel, they speak the lingo of the channel, and they know how partners work and what they want. So I think even though, yes, he's new to Microsoft and he does have some challenges, 27 years of working in the channel, and also he's excited to be working directly under people who also have direct channel knowledge. Because as I understand it, Neil Tanner used to run his own partner business back in the day for 7 years. So I think that will make a big difference in their partnership. And going forward, that's got to be exciting.
Yeah, Neil Tanner is the one who hired Greg Larnder, and yeah, let's face it, though, he's going to have to mend some fences in the channel because he's been competing with these same channel partners who are now going to have to help him out. So I think it's going to be interesting, but you're right, he has 27 years of experience. He is Canadian. This is not like a parachute drop-off executive from the United States. So I do think it's positive, and it's someone that they desperately need right now.
Okay, and now let's talk about Office 365 Open. What do you know about that, and how do you think it'll change things for the partners?
Well, you know, the partners were so enthusiastic about this program because, Christine, they, for the first time, will be able to directly bill the customer. Now, that was something that Microsoft, you know, helped them out with, right? They wanted them to focus on, you know, selling and not really like managing the administrator part of it. And you know, what the channel partners told me was, this is really, really important because it allows them to own the customer. And you know, now Microsoft's a 100% channel-friendly company, but not every other vendor is like that. So they always have to worry about channel conflict. And so direct billing, it was something that they really desperately wanted, and Microsoft's worldwide channel chief, John Roskell, delivered that. We talked to Neil Tanner, and he also said that this is going to be given for the Canadian market. So I don't know how, you know, I don't understand how direct billing really correlates to owning the customer. I think that's one little tiny factor in all that. But it's good to know that, you know, that it was a positive step forward for the channel base, and they have that. If they so need. So what are your thoughts on Office 365?
Well, I think basically you're right. The little bit of information that I have gleaned from some of the Canadian partners on the show floor is that it is something they're looking forward to, that they want to spend less time on administrative and billing things and just, you know, cut through the bureaucratic red tape and make it an easier process for them. And maybe now is a good time to just promote the fact that in the next segment, we are going to talk some more about the Office 365 Open program with Darren Bibby from IDC. And he's got a lot more to say on his take on that new program.
And also stay tuned for my one-on-one interview with Max Long, the new president of Microsoft Canada. He's going to be following Darren Bibby.